Welcome to
the Flower Nerds.
The Flower Nerds.
The Flower Nerds. That's us, isn't it?
That is us.
It's you.
It's you. This is Jan.
You're Hank.
And I'm Hank.
And you know us already, don't you?
And we are doing a flower fact-packed episode of Flower Nerds, and we're talking about carnation.
Yes, because we always want to tell you everything you need to know about one type of flower.
Carnations. And carnations have an image problem, and we are going to solve it.
We are, because we know all about image problems.
Image problems.
But enough about that. It will be interesting coming along, because we've got things like
history, symbolism, colours, where does the name come from? Oh, it's endless. There's so many interesting facts about carnations.
Isn't there? I was amazed.
I love it! I can't wait to see everything!
So, come along. See you later.
Carnifacts! So how did carnations get their name? Well, there is a very big flowering group of plants family, and they're called Dianthus. And there was a Greek botanist, Theophrastus, who came up with the name Dianthos, which is part dios, part anthos, which is divine flower. So it was basically the flower of the gods. In 1753, Carl Linnaeus mentions the carnation in his Species Plantarium for the very first time, and he coins the term Dianthus caryophyllus. That's how it got its name.
Carnifacts. Carnations probably originate in the Pyrenees as a single flower specimen, but none of these wild occurring specimen plants exist today. Their exact range is difficult to know exactly due to extensive cultivation for 2000 years. In the past, their first uses was as garlands for the Greeks and the Romans.
A sight to make armchair gardeners squirm. It's the planting out season for carnation seedlings. Blooms of Tomorrow are getting the featherbed treatment under glass at a carnation farm near Worthing. This is how they keep them growing straight and healthy. A string box for every plant that's a guideline to growth. In 2 years, they'll be 8 feet high. Temperature never falls below 52, because this is where they can turn on their own weather. And they're planning an automated climate control under this 14-acre garden empire of glass, where the Saturday afternoon hobby becomes full-scale industry. £20,000 is the annual turnover. But the basic raw material, light, is free, provided it can get in. So if you want to know how to make a business out of blossoms, this is where you learn. Like Sister Alex here, who will start a market garden at her convent back in Ireland. One thing you'll find out, not every carnation flower is allowed to stay the course. You pick off all but the topmost buds, so that in the plant's 2-year life cycle, you grow 80 top-class blooms for every foot of soil. When the precious flowers have opened out, they're ready to be picked. An all the year-round crop with a busy boom in midsummer. Here at Worthing, they've perfected a petal production line. Packed with speed and care, 3 dozen to the box, they're sent to every corner of the country to make every day seem like spring. Flowers that are always a fresh bank of beauty in a world that's often all too keen to uproot and change.
Carnifact! So carnations are the national flower of Slovenia, Monaco, Spain, and the red carnation is one of the 5
national flowers of Portugal. Five national flowers.
Carnifex. The original colours of carnations were pink and peach, but very soon you could get colours like yellow, white, red, purple, and even green. Due to extensive breeding programs, you also got different shapes of flowers. So you had single, semi-double, and double. And these were available in all those colors and even more, sort of in between colors. And on top of that, also in all these colors, you could get veined, striped, stippled, and spotted varieties with either smooth edged petals or picoteed edges. A massive variety.
So we've got some carnations. Look, loads of them. I am planning on doing something with them, sew them together, and I was thinking maybe to do a piece of clothing or something, because I do like clothes. I'm using a little bit of real wire, and as you can see, I'm sewing them together one by one. Two panels, and I'll make sort of a front and back panel of something wearable. Neat rows of like a lined stripy jumper, but with lots of stem to it, which makes it actually quite heavy. So I'm sort of wondering if I will be able to wear it. I have some still left, so I might do a little headdress as well, because it's just easy. I'm working on my headdress, and look, I've got a little strand already. Ooh. I'm just sort of breaking them off under the head really shortly, and then sort of sewing them onto a real wire. Where is her? A lovely hula hula. Oh, I think this will be quite nice as well. That looks like a lovely crown to me. I'm sort of wearing something. Look. Sort of all around, and it's got carnations, and I'm sort of quite impressed with myself. It looks like a little mini dress. Oh, look, aren't I the carnation queen? I'll do a little like catwalk in the garden for you. Hiya, so here's my finished product dress. Look. Flowers everywhere around me. I'm clad in them, and I've got my lovely headdress. Ooh, you look pretty. Got a bit of movement rather than this very static flower crowd. Well, I hope you enjoyed my little carnation creation. It smells beautiful. So I think carnations are totally it. Carnifex! So carnations are subdivided in a lot of specific classes. There's the Picotee, there's the Flame, the Flake, and the Bizarre. We like that last one. Picotees are splotched or spotted with red or purple or mauve, sort of different colors. The Flame is basically striped with red or black. The Flake is sort of striped with more different colors, two different colors. And then the Bizarre is like has up to four different colors in the same flower. Oh, looks beautiful.
Carnifex. The early Christians believed that carnations bloomed and grew where Mary wept for Jesus carrying the cross. There he is. Hello! Right, we've got to go, come on.
Sorry.
Yay! We're here.
We are at the National Gallery.
We're gonna find some carnations.
We are looking, hunting, scouring. We are gonna find carnations in art.
Yay!
And look at the beautiful building. We are the Flower Nerds.
And today we're gonna find carnations.
Flower Nerds!
Where are we?
We are at the National Gallery, and we are looking for carnations in art. Hello, dear flower nerds.
We're going to find some carnations in art, aren't we?
This is the best gallery in the world, the British National Gallery.
The better be one, otherwise.
Yeah, we are determined to find carnations.
It'll be an empty journey.
Been able to find any paintings of the Virgin Mary with carnations, because it's often associated with carnations. But now we are meticulously looking at every single detail in these flower stems to see if we can spot the carnation.
Hank, do you think we've found a carnation?
I'm sure we found carnations. Look at this little flower here. This. A beautiful flame carnation. And there's another one peeking out here on the bottom.
Is it a picotee or a curious or...
I think it might be a picotee. But look, it's like even the tulips and the anemones, everything is flamed in this painting. And this is by Ambrosius Bosschaert, the elder.
Is he Dutch?
I think he's Belgian as well.
Oh no.
Yeah, painted in around 1600.
Yes, Belgians did get around, didn't they?
Yeah, they were quite popular back in the days.
But they were. This stripy effect was obviously very, very popular in those days.
Yeah.
But now we know that it's caused by a terrible disease.
It's just a virus.
It's just a virus.
Yeah. We found another lovely still life here with carnations. Look at this beauty. Another stripy picotee. And this one is by Balthasar van der Ast.
Is he Dutch?
He is Dutch.
Vander
must be Dutch.
From the what?
From the what? Van der Ast.
What does Ast mean?
Ast. I don't know really. It's just the name, isn't it?
From the something no one
from
knows.
The, I don't know. He trained with the other guy. The
did he?
Yes.
Did he? This is such a nice room.
This is a beautiful
I'm
room.
I'm glad we found this
and,
room.
And then we got lovely shells and. Details of little insects that are in the flowers and a moth.
Live or dead.
So it's all vanitas, it's about the circle of life.
The circle of life.
And then celebrating this rich, beautiful
I can feel a song coming up.
So, we found in the National Gallery that most of the paintings with carnations are actually not on display.
Oh, no. They're even out of favour in here.
So I think there's a duty for us to make them, popularise them.
Could you not start painting some or drawing some and turn them popular again?
I can. If you start using them.
I'm using them all the time.
I know you are.
If we can't have carnations in art, maybe we can have it in fashion.
You can have carnations with Jan and Hank.
We spoke too early.
We found another carnation picture.
We did, and it's right behind us.
Have and it's got lots of symbolism.
Here's a still life that shows a lot of symbolism for the Virgin Mary. There's the water and the lily, which is meant to symbolize her purity. The finch is meant to symbolize Christ's passion and sacrifice. And as we know from our earlier research, the carnation was meant to flower where Christ's blood fell at the crucifixion. Small correction, it's actually where Mary's tears fell. There's also less pure associations as a these lemons are quite suggestive of breast filled with milk. So the whole thing by this Catholic Spanish painter is for the Virgin Mary.
Surprise, we find in the museum shop the little Bruegel the Elder as merchandise. Look, he's got carnations all over his body and got a t-shirt or a pillow.
Well, it's like what I said before.
Or a little tin.
It's carnations it's in fashion.
Completely commercialized.
Let's have a look at the cushion.
The cushion? Oh, the cushion is gorgeous. Look, you want to just lay your head on there.
Oh. Flowers.
I'm tempted to buy the face mask.
Oh, that's cool.
Face mask.
How much are
they? With carnations. 15 quid only.
Carn effects. Some of their therapeutic uses. Carnation essential oil has been known to have many benefits to the individual. Carnation essential oil can work as an anti-inflammatory. It can work against hair loss. It can work as a muscle relaxant. And it also helps against excess gas. None of these problems will I have, I hasten to add. In addition to these benefits, carnation essential oil can also help the skin in many different ways. It's good against rashes, it can work as a skin conditioner, it can work for wrinkles, it can also help with various skin conditions such as rosacea and eczema. In the beauty industry, carnation oil has been used to moisten and soften the skin. Carnation flowers have also been used in massage oil to soften the skin and give a soothing and calming scent.
Carny facts! So, carnations are edible flowers. They look delicious. The University of Kentucky College of Agriculture produced a list of edible species and carnations was in there. But a little bit strange, they also had a mention that they are poisonous. They could get you seriously ill or even cause death. So very strange. But most carnations actually are very bland and they can be very bitter. So I wouldn't really suggest eating them. But they do look delicious. Colors. If you gave me fresh colors.